Please subscribe to my channel, Audio Novels. Thank you. See playlist for other chapters and novels. Book 2, Academy of Monsters, Chapter 10.1. First experience with soul tools. Teacher Zuyi was incomparably domineering when she was in front of her students, but she seemed to have completely lost that tyranny when she was in front of this middle-aged man named Fan Yu. She amiably said, "I'm referring to what you brought up last time, the matter regarding spiritual type soul masters using soul tools." When he heard what she said, Fan Yu's eyes couldn't help but light up. His gaze subconsciously fell on huoyuhao, who was standing to the side. "He has a spiritual type martial soul?" Zuyi nodded her head and said, "Correct. His name is huoyuhao, and he's a new student. He has a spiritual type body soul." After seriously looking over huoyuhao, Fan Yu shook his head and said, "This won't do. His body and soul force are both too weak. I'm afraid that he won't even be able to control one of the weakest soul tools. Furthermore, his talent is similar to the current state of his body. It's too far away from what I need." Zuyi humphed and replied, "Are you looking down on my foresight?" "True. Huoyuhao is still weak right now, but his soul skill is extraordinary. It's the most practical spiritual type skill that I've ever seen." "Huoyuhao, let him experience it for a moment." "Oh." As a student, huoyuhao could only participate as a spectator right now. He immediately activated his spiritual detection sharing and used it on the middle-aged man. Following that, huoyuhao was so startled that he almost lost focus. When his spiritual detection sharing came into contact with the middle-aged man, the latter slightly furrowed his brow. In that instant, huoyuhao felt as if there was a terrifying beast in front of him that had suddenly opened its maw, as if it wanted to swallow him in one gulp. This feeling even caused the sleeping sky dream ICU worm to wake up. A refreshing feeling appeared in his spiritual sea, causing huoyuhao's astonishment and horror to disappear. The terrifying aura that was emanating from Fan Yu's body disappeared after only appearing for an instant. As soon as it did, he allowed huoyuhao's spiritual detection sharing to link with him. After a short moment, Fan Yu discovered the subtleties contained within huoyuhao's spiritual detection sharing. Great waves immediately rose inside of his originally peaceful eyes. "There's actually a spiritual type skill like this. How could a skill like this come from a 10-year soul beast?" Fan Yu looked at the white soul ring floating below huoyuhao's body with a puzzled look. In addition to the puzzled look on his face, he also had a surprised look. Huoyuhao naturally wouldn't mention the sky dream icy worm, so the wind baboon became his excuse once again. "A 10-year wind baboon?" Fan Yu and Zuyi were both speechless. Zuyi gazed at Fan Yu and said, "Could this be a mutated soul skill?" Fan Yu nodded his head and said, "There's a chance. This little guy's martial soul is a body soul, and a spiritual type one at that. His existence in and of itself is a mutation. Furthermore, the soul beast that he chose for a soul ring is an existence that's completely incompatible with him. This must have triggered an extremely rare soul skill mutation." The fact that a spiritual type martial soul didn't suffer a backlash from absorbing a wind type soul ring is already a miracle, but I didn't think that a mutation like this would appear. "I'm afraid that this is a miracle that would be completely impossible to reproduce. Kaitu, come here." Fan Yu beckoned towards the group of people standing next to the wall. A youth immediately rushed over. When he saw the youth, huoyuhao couldn't help but be startled. From his face, he didn't look to be much look older than however, he was extremely tall, over 2 meters tall. His shoulders were even wider than Fan Yu's, while his naked upper body exposed his tanned muscles. There wasn't any hair on his head, and he was much more tanned than an ordinary person. He had a simple and honest appearance. "Teacher." The youth bowed respectfully towards Fan Yu. Fan Yu pointed at huoyuhao and said, "Go and fire a round of the stationary soul cannon. Let this kid support you, and try to hit a moving target." "Yes." The tanned youth didn't ask any questions. He smiled simple-mindedly at huoyuhao and said, "Little brother, follow me." Zuyi said, "Huoyuhao, just use that skill of yours to support him." "Yes." Huoyuhao now somewhat understood why Zuyi had brought him here. He hurriedly chased after the tanned youth. "Nice to meet you, little brother. My name's Hikaitu, but everyone simply calls me Kaitu. Thus, you can just call me Kaitu. The tanned youth gave Huoyuhao another simple-minded smile. Huoyuhao replied, nice to meet you, big brother He. I'm Huoyuhao. When he said the three words, big brother He, Hikaitu became stunned for a moment. After he'd recovered, he gave Huoyuhao a big thumbs up and said, little brother, you're not bad. Even future historians wouldn't know that the friendship between Eyes of the Azura Huoyuhao and Origin of Destruction Hikaitu had actually started from a simple sentence like this. When the two had arrived at the edge of the testing field, Hikaitu tapped the black belt on his waist, causing a light to flash, and an item that was extremely strange looking, in Huoyuhao's opinion, appeared in his hand. It was a roughly 1.5 meter long tube made of black metal. Its cross-sectional diameter was around 15 centimeters, while its tail was slightly thicker. It had many mysterious patterns carved on it. Hikaitu held it in an extremely proficient manner. After pressing the back of the metal tube with his right hand twice, a cover immediately came off, revealing a hold that was approximately 20 centimeters long and 10 centimeters wide. He quickly tapped his waist with his left hand once again, causing a shuttle-shaped piece of metal to appear in his hand. He carefully placed it into the exposed hole in the metal tube, before carefully putting the cover back on. When he raised his right hand, the metal tube landed on his right shoulder. Hikaitu, who'd previously given off an extremely simple feeling, suddenly had a large change in temperament when he raised the metal tube to his shoulder. Huoyuhao's martial soul was a spiritual type 1, thus his keen level of awareness caused him to feel a strong sense of danger from Hikaitu all of a sudden. Huoyuhao, let's start. Hikaitu's voice echoed out. A golden light flickered through Huoyuhao's eyes, and his spiritual detection sharing accurately landed on Hikaitu's body. Hikaitu's eyes exuded a trace of astonishment, and he excitedly shouted into the distance, moving target, fire. There seemed to be someone controlling the targets from the other side. With a swoosh, a disc-shaped object shot out from a corner in the distance, and was headed directly towards Huoyuhao and Hikaitu. At that moment, a strong undulation of soul force instantly exploded from Hikaitu's body. Three soul rings, two yellow and one purple, all simultaneously flashed, and the metal tube on his shoulder seemed to tremble slightly. A strong halo of black light began to revolve around the surface of the metal tube, and Hikaitu's body gently moved. The metal tube was now aimed at the round disc flying towards them at high speed. Bang! A violent explosion echoed out, and the metal tube instantly released a dazzling black light. The huge amount of turbulence that suddenly appeared caused Huoyuhao to stumble and almost fall down. However, the black light didn't hit the flying round disc. Instead, it brushed past it, and flew into the distance. After it had traversed 100 or so meters, it collided fiercely with a metal plate in the distance, causing a violent explosion to erupt. An enormous stream of air bounded straight towards them, causing Hikaitu to quickly move to protect Huoyuhao behind him. The air current lasted a few seconds before it gradually calmed down. On the other hand, the round disc didn't fly out of the testing area, but rather landed near them. Please subscribe to my channel, Audio Novels. Thank you.